Hello students, we have started the lesson Nelson Mandela Long Walk to Freedom and we have read that on the inauguration ceremony there were lakhs of people and also dignitaries, world leaders to watch the South Africa to be a complete independent country, a democratic country and we have already read that two vice presidents and president has taken their oath and next we have also learned what Mandela has said on this great occasion and what he is saying. So next that was rest that we have left on yesterday, today I am going to complete. In life every man has twin obligations, obligations to his family, to his parents, to his wife and children, and he has an obligation to his people, his community, his country. Here Mandela says that every person in the world has two obligations. One obligation is that obligation to his family, to parents, to his wife and children, and the second obligation for his people, his community and for his country. In a civil and human society, that means in a civilized society, each man is able to fulfill those obligations according to his own inclinations, abilities, and every person is able to fulfill these obligations according to his ability, according to his power, according to his capacity. But in a country like South Africa, it was almost impossible for a man of my birth and color to fulfill both those obligations. But at that time, when in South Africa, when the white ruled over the black, it was impossible for a man like him to complete, to fulfill these obligations. In South Africa, a man of color who attempted to live as a human being was punished and isolated. Look, a man who tried to do this, to try to fulfill these obligations, were punished and was made isolated. In South Africa, a man who tried to fulfill his duty to his people was inevitably ripped from his family and his home and was forced to live a life apart, a twilight existence of secrecy and alienation. A person who tried to fulfill the responsibility to his family, to his country, to his people, he was ripped from his family, he was taken away from his family and he had to live a life of rebellion, a life of secrecy, that he was not able to live a life of to live an independent life. I did not in the beginning choose to place my people above my family, but in attempting to serve my people, I found that I was prevented from fulfilling my obligations as a son, a brother, a father and a husband. Look what he said. When he chose to fulfill the responsibility to his people above his family, then he found that in doing so, he was prevented to fulfill the duty, the obligations to obligations as a son, as a brother, as a sister, as a husband, whatever. That means he was not able to fulfill the obligations for his family and others. I was not born with a hunger to be free. He said that he was not born to be a hunger of free, to be free. I was born free. He was born free because everyone is born free. Free in every way that I could know. I have free to run in the fields near my mother's hut, free to swim in the clear stream that ran through my village, free to roast mealies under the stars and ride the broad backs of slow-moving bulls. Look, that means as a child, he was free to do everything what he liked. He wanted to play freely, he wanted to run freely, he wanted to swim freely, he wanted to ride freely. As long as I obeyed my father and abided by the customs of my tribe, I was not troubled by the laws of man or god. That means when he was child and when he obeyed his father and abided the customs of his society, he was not troubled by any laws or made by man or god. It was only when I began to learn that my boyhood freedom was an illusion, when I discovered as a young man that my freedom had already been taken from me, that I began to hunger for it. And when he became young, he came to know that his freedom was curtailed. He was not free to do everything. He was not free to run. He was not free to do anything in his country. And that is why he started searching his freedom. At first, as a student, I wanted freedom only for myself. The transitory freedoms of being able to stay out at night, read what I please and go where I chose. As a student, at first he wanted freedom for himself only. He wanted to do himself, freely everything himself, not for others. Later, as a young man in Johannesburg, I earned for the basic and honorable freedoms of achieving my potential, of earning my keep, of marrying and having a family, the freedom not to be obstructed in a lawful life. Then, when he became a young person in Johannesburg, he he was able to his potential of earning his keep, he was able to marry, have a family. He started a family, and at that time the law was not disturbing at him anymore. But then I slowly saw that not only was I not free, but my brothers and sisters were not free. But after that, he came to know, he understood that not only he, but also his brother, sister, everyone was not free. I saw that it was not just my freedom that was curtailed. At that time, he found that not only his freedom was curtailed, but the freedom of everyone who looked like I did. That means he found that according the black person of their society were suffering from that death. That means the freedoms of all were curtailed. That is when I joined the African National Congress, and that is when the hunger for my own freedom became the greater hunger for the freedom of my people, and thus the hunger for freedom of his own had become the hunger for every person of South Africa. It was the desire for the freedom of my people to live their lives with dignity and self-respect that animated my life. And this hunger for freedom for everyone, for all free black person of South Africa, gave him life to live. That the transformed a frightened young man into a bold one, and this desire change him from a frightened young man to a brave one or bold one. That drove law abiding attorney to become a criminal, and also made this law abiding attorney to a criminal. That turned a family loving husband into a man without a home, and family loving man become a houseless man, homeless man, and forced a life living man to live like a monk. And he was forced to live a like a monk. I am no more virtuous or self-sacrificing than the next man, but I found that I could not even enjoy the poor and the limited freedoms I was allowed when I knew my people were not free. And that means whatever freedom he was getting, he thought that he was not able to enjoy that because he found that his people were not free to enjoy that. Freedom is invisible. The chains on any one of my people were the chains on all of them. That's if any person of his society, his race, is suffering from this kind of things, then it means that he is also suffering the same. The chains I knew that the oppressor must be liberated just as surely as the oppressed. He thought that the oppressor and the oppressed must be liberated. A man who takes away another man's freedom is a prison of hatred. A man who takes the freedom of another, he is the prisoner of hatred. That means he must be a man of hatred. We should not respect him. If a man takes the freedom of another, he must be a person of hatred because he is not a man. He is not social. He is not kind. He is locked behind the bars of prejudice and narrow-mindedness. That look, because he is in the hand of prejudice. You know, prejudice or narrow-mindedness. Narrow-mindedness, he is not broad-looking. His thinking is not broad. I am not truly free if I am taking away someone else's freedom. And if I am taking someone's freedom, that I am also not free. Just as surely as I am free when my freedom is taken from me, the oppressed and the oppressor alike are robbed of him of their humanity. That means if the oppressor and the oppressed both are alike, because they are both are robbed of humanity. That means completing this lesson, we must know that what Mandela has said at that time. As you know, that South Africa, the land of South Africa, was at until 1914. Oh no, we have already let until 1914 the black were ruled by the white. 1994, the black were ruled by the white, and after 30 years of a struggle, Nelson Mandela and his national African National Congress Party was able to bring a democratic country in South Africa. And he said that if a person hates another, then the person is himself a person of a man of hatred. Because in this world, no one has been born to be slave. No one has been born to be slave. All human beings, all human races are born free. We are free to live our life happily, to do according to our wish. Now, thank you, students. And I will send you tomorrow the important board model questions. And you have to do it. And also send me to my personal WhatsApp number. Thank you.